Hey there, you get picked on a roll call. Think of the lion, the bravest of all. He doesn't hang his head down and let his eyes fall. He lifts his head up and lets out a roar. Think of the chicken who gets pecked at in the barn. If she strutted like a rooster, she'd be safe on that farm. Stand tall and walk with your head held high. People can't hurt you if you smile and not cry. You see, most folks will treat you how you treat them and yourself. We're all born equal, so have respect for yourself. It's all in the bravado you present society. It's the way that winners live in glory. Stand tall and walk with your head held high. People can't hurt you if you smile and not cry. Show them you're worthy of dignity, because you're a descendant of Adam and Eve. You see, they're only looking for someone to make them feel big, but the true greatness of the person is in their hearts, you dig. Stand tall and walk with your head held high. People can't hurt you if you smile and not cry. You don't frighten me is the image you need to project. If your aim is to self-protect, bullying can't be solved with revengeful abuse. When you're punished, you'll have no excuse. Just ignore bullies and they'll go away. Focus on the things that brighten your day. So stand tall and walk with your head held high. People can't hurt you if you smile and not cry.
Oh yeah.
G'day, I'm Captain Australia Bear. And this is my mate, Aussie Yucca Bear.
G'day, mate.
And we're here today to teach the kids some good things about being good little Aussies. First of all, it's important on a hot summer's day to slip on a shirt, slop on some sunscreen, and slap on a hat. It's very important this hot Aussie sun to slip on a shirt, slop on a sunscreen, and slap on a hat. Because this harsh Australian sun is just so harsh. Oh right, that's great mate, that's great. And did you know why it's so important for us to slip on a shirt, slop on some sunscreen and slap on a hat? Well, because not everybody has the dark skin in Australia. Not all little Australian Aussies have the dark skin like from some children whose parents were born in another country like Africa or India. Not every little Australian has the dark skin. For example, this little child here was born in Australia, but he's a little Australian child, but he's still got the dark skin from his background, which may have been African or it may have been Indian. Okay, so he's got very dark skin, and in Africa and India, the sun is very, very hot. And little Aboriginal children too, they have very dark skin as well. The little children have little African and little Indian and little Aboriginal children, for example, have dark skin, and that protects them from the very, very hot sun. But on the other hand, this way over here. On the other hand, this little boy, his parents came from England. He was born in Australia. He's Australian too, just like the other little boy over there. And he's Australian too, and his parents were born in England, but his parents might have been born in some country like Holland as well, because he's got very fair skin. So we have children from all over the world in multicultural Australia who were born in Australia now, because their parents came to Australia from another country. And they've got fair skin, because in places like England and Scandinavia, it's a bit cooler there, and the sun isn't so hot there, and that's why they've got the fairy skin.
Well, hello there, little girl. What's your name?
My name's Judy.
Jacob. Hi there, Judy. That rings a bell.
That
face. I've seen that face before. Don't you have a friend whose name is Punch?
Yes, that's right. There used to be a Punch and Judy show.
Oh, why isn't there a Punch and Judy show anymore? Because of what you taught me about standing tall and walking with my head held high. Punch doesn't punch anymore. There is no punch in the act anymore. It's just me, sweet little Judy, enjoying the sunshine. Oh, that's lovely. The punch doesn't punch anymore. That's right, there's no punch. He doesn't bother me anymore. He doesn't bully me anymore. He doesn't punch anymore. Because I just simply walk away, stand tall with my head held high. Just get away as quickly as you can, without looking afraid. Just be confident. They need to see that you're confident. That's right. You can look tough, but you don't have to be violent back. Oh, that's right. Because violence brings violence. That's right. And peace brings peace. That's right. World peace starts right there, where you are, there and then. World peace starts right there, where you are, there and then. I got it. I've got it. That's right. Lock it into your memory banks. World peace starts right there, where you are. Right there. Okay. All right, thank you. And Miss V, I'm sure people have hurt her feelings. Miss V, the hummingbird, some people have hurt her feelings, but she's been reading the Good News book. The Good News book. Miss V's been reading the Good News book. And JC teaches to love your enemies, to bless those who hurt you, and do good to them. And your Heavenly Father, Miss V's Heavenly Father, sees everything and says that He will get revenge on her behalf. He will punish the wrongdoers. But it's very important not to laugh when those people suffer for their sins. It's very important not to laugh at them when God causes them to suffer for the things they've done wrong to you. It's very important not to laugh at them, because we're all God's children. God loves everyone, even the bullies. And keep the spirit of Christmas in your heart all year round. Roof, roof.
Santa loves the girls and boys, being good through all the years. Friends will be and good cheer.
To be wise. in times when we don't know. Let this be our prayer when we lose our way. Lead us to a place, guide us with your grace.